They change the time, some of the time into elective courses, which we can learn the civic leaders.
Okay, so they're going to cut any content or just the time for those classes?
Yes, they will cut some of them.
Okay, and you're saying that you're going to change the grade calculation for the grade.
Yes, the time just because in the one I proved them, they decrease the credits you need to be to graduate. Thus, in the previous curriculum, you need at least 160 credits to graduate.
Okay. And so you're saying the teacher's importance is the, can I have the evidence for the importance of the teacher's guidance? And also, you said that you can prove that cutting the school time is not doing any good for the students.
This is what you are debating on.
Oh, so you don't have proof of that?
Reducing
the school hours doesn't do any good for the students. Do you have? Okay.
This is what we are.
Oh, okay. And you're saying that you deny our 8 to 10 hours sleeping time.
Yes, because the research is sponsored by companies who manufacture sleep medicine. Yes.
Okay. And you say that the importance of teaching is the way of concentration is the way that teachers teach.
Yes.
So if teachers think they're teaching, would the students get more concentrated in class?
Of course, teachers' teaching method affects the students' conditions and concentration in class.
So if teachers change their teaching ways, then that would be do good to the students.
Of course, writing in the current state.
Okay, and you're saying that autonomous learning, in your script you mentioned autonomous learning?
Yes, the main goal, one of the goals of the online curriculum is to make students learn autonomous. Make them learn autonomous. They will want to learn by themselves. They have the passion to learn.
In classes, at school,
in classes, just about learning whenever they are at school or at home. Yes.
Okay.
Wherever they are.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, honorable judges and fellow debaters. We, the affirmative, strongly believe that we should reduce the hour of time secondary school students spend at school each day. Now I'm going to review some points made by the negative. First of all, they said that sleep deprivation could be fixed by simply postponing school time. But that is not the only thing we're trying to fix. And the reality is that 69.3% of Taiwanese students don't actually have enough time to do things apart from schoolwork after school. If the ending time of school is delayed because of their postponing, because of their plan, then this situation would only get worse. And they said that our Israel evidence is done within elementary school students, but it clearly states on the evidence that it's done among middle schoolers. Also, they said that In their plan, they would help students pursue their interest by providing elective courses in the 101 curriculum. But we would like to point out that it is simply impossible for schools to open the amount of courses needed to satisfy everyone's interest. And they said that in our plan, we were going to reduce school hours, which would result in reducing the content that the students learned. But we have, I want to point out that we have not reduced the content of the academic subjects, and only the style of teaching for some subjects. Their plan, however, is going to reduce the content of crucial subjects such as Chinese and math, as they said in the cross-examination, which would affect Taiwanese students. And our evidence, they said that our evidence about students having no time to pursue their interest after school is done among elementary school. But we would like to point out that the evidence says that it's separated into two groups, elementary school and middle schoolers. And for the group of middle schoolers, it does indeed show that 69.3% of Taiwanese middle schoolers don't actually have the time to use after school. And they said that their plan would help students to pursue their interest. But I would like to point out that, again, they cannot provide the amount of elective courses we need for. So now that I have refuted the negative points, let me further explain the affirmative plan in more details. As my partner has previously mentioned, we have altered the starting time of secondary school to around 9 a.m., which makes it possible for most students to get a healthy amount of sleep, and the ending time to 3 p.m., which allows students to have more time to either study about their interests freely, or go to different classes outside, or catch up with their schoolwork. They will have 10 minutes of homeroom at the start of every day. This plan comes with several additional changes to the school subjects. First of all, students do not have to take all three art subjects. They only need to choose one art subject according to their interest every semester. Secondly, we have combined three social studies into one theme-based teaching curriculum, where students learn history, geography, and civil ethics through exploring different topics. According to a Michigan University report, this style of teaching makes classes much more efficient and make it much easier for students to connect everything they learn. Developed countries such as Finland and Sweden are already using this method. Also, according to Ling Yunzhu, the chief planner of Boston Consulting Group, Taiwanese students are capable of this kind of teaching and would benefit from it. These changes enabled us to fit a new type of class to the schedule, elective courses. These courses aim to provide a more advanced knowledge on different subjects students can choose from. This helps students develop a more profound understanding on their field of interest. The teachers that would teach these courses have to take advanced training. After 3 p.m., students are free to leave school and are encouraged to participate in different outside classes related to their own personal interests. For those who choose not to leave school because of different reasons, we would provide classrooms for them to study in. For rural areas, or those whose family is under the poverty line, however, teachers will be offered extra pay to use their existing skills or knowledge to open optional courses for students. This is because we're aware of the fact that the lack of resources in rural areas make it hard for students to find outside classes to attend. The budget for this would come from high school actualization program. Aside from school content, we also made some changes to the type of entrance exam students take. Students no longer have to take all 12 subjects. They only need to choose to take tests about subjects their future university requires. As for how we will execute this plan, we would cut time for all secondary schools starting in the year of 108. As for the elective courses, they would first be put to work. Having explained our plan and after stating why the negative points do not stand, we the affirmative firmly believe that Taiwanese government should reduce the time that secondary school students spend at school each day. And that was the total of the
Welcome back to
cross
examination.
Middle schoolers all over Taiwan.
Okay. So what is the biggest factor which caused this question? That caused that they're not free time?
Because the school ending time is too late.
So was it mentioned in your evidence or you just made it?
It shows that they don't have enough time after school to
So do you admit that there are a lot of possibilities which cause this problem? Like maybe they are going to crime schools. There are many possibilities. It is not necessarily because of school.
But in our plan, we're actually giving
the evidence didn't mention that it's because it's right because of the school.
The evidence mentioned that they don't have enough time after school.
Okay, thank you. So given that you are combining social studies, are you training the teachers to teach?
Well, because right now we have three different teachers for each social studies courses. So for those classes, the teachers would sometimes teach by themselves, or they sometimes would combine the subjects together, and the three teachers would teach them together.
Okay. So you mentioned about the optional classes. So can normal students also attend?
They could, but they have to pay for it.
Okay. So the optional classes are mainly for the poor?
Yeah, that's the main purpose.
Okay. So you mentioned that you are using a new teaching way called theme-based teaching. So do you have evidence telling that students would like this?
We have evidence showing that Taiwanese students would actually benefit from this kind of teaching.
So can you show that? So it shows that Taiwanese students would benefit from this, but the evidence say that they really accept this kind of teaching.
We have evidence showing that Taiwanese students are actually suitable for this kind of teaching.
So you are reducing school hours. So are you aware of the minimum teaching hours of teachers? So how will you?
Well, for teachers, because we're offering elective courses, so some of the teachers would go teach those elective courses, and for other teachers who can't reach their minimum working hours, they would have jobs such as homework teachers or students office teachers.
Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, today the affirmative has shown many evidence to us and we really appreciate that. But we would like to talk about their evidence. First of all, the National Safety Foundation evidence is founded by the drug companies, which had no credibility toward this. The sleeping deprivation part, it proves nothing. And there's a piece of evidence that they gave us. It's from Israel and telling us that school time do affect adolescents, though it is not mentioned in the evidence card because they cut the crucial contents of their evidence card to make it look trustful. It is actually based on 572 fifth graders. The survey is based on these fifth graders. How does it imply to our topic today? And another survey from this is that students don't have their free time, that like 69% or something, students don't have their free time. Though it is based on elementary school students too. It is right on the evidence card. So it doesn't make sense to me since it doesn't even apply to our topic. And there's a piece of evidence that is from us. It meets their plan, that is moving the schedule from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. It is from the Administration of Education in 2018. It gathers experts and professions and do research toward this kind of plan, and it points out many problems like condensed courses and influence the specified number of teachers at school and their basic working hours, so it doesn't sound feasible to us at all. The affirmative first reason was sleep deprivation. They said that long hours of school contributes to a student's sleep deprivation, that they believe cutting off school hours can solve this problem, though the phenomenon can be caused by several factors, including addiction of internet, one's in the surroundings, personal relation status. Teenagers often somehow sacrifice their sleeping time for these entertaining activities, with no direct evidence pointing out the relation between existing school hours to sleep deprivation. They failed to prove its inherency. Their second reason was lack of concentration. They said that long hours at school comprised of academic lessons make the students exhausted, which later lead to inefficiency in both learning and teaching. But we like to have two responses. First, to deal with this problem, there's no need to cut off school hours. Second, once we shorten the time at school, lessons will rather be more condensed or hasty. Schoolwork, on the other hand, will become homework for the students, which they need to digest in their own time. Their third reason was free time. This is that time for extracurricular activities is often squeezed out by school hours. In the feminist case, they think that cutting off school, the earlier the school is over, the more time they can put in participating in their interests. But quality is superior to quantity. Schools are institutions that offer well-planned programs with professionally trained teachers to help guide the pupils. Interest discovery should be included inside the school's lecture. Without the school's lead, it's very possible that the students will waste their extra time from reduced school hours. Having time for extracurricular or not really depends on themselves. After studying the current schedule, with a negative but only one harm, is that in the light of psychology in action, research shows that melatonin levels rise about 2 hours later in a day for adolescents.